Five receivers spread the formation for Cincinnati.
Man-to-man down here with Bins, again with Chappelle. It's been something he's liked all day. A whole lot of field to work with.
Cincinnati 28 yards and an extra point away from taking the lead. To the end zone it goes! Caught! Touchdown, Armon Bins! Flag down, line of scrimmage.
Tony Pike's game-winning touchdown pass down the sideline to Armon Bins has cemented itself as one of the greatest moments in Bearcats football history. The Cincinnati Bearcats, led by head coach Brian Kelly in 2009, are one of the most historic and greatest teams in the school's history. They rallied to a perfect season, undefeated in 12 games, winning the Big East championship for the second year in a row. And although they were ranked third in the BCS standings, it was not enough to send the Bearcats to the national championship. The Bearcats' 2009 season started with a 47-15 blowout at Rutgers with an explosive performance from returning starting quarterback Tony Pike. Pike threw for a career-high of 362 yards, accompanied by three touchdown passes, including this one to running back Isaiah Pete. Hosting their first home game of the regular season, Brian Kelly's Bearcats steamroll Southeast Missouri State 70-3 with spectacular special teams performances from the Bearcats, including a punt return touchdown from Audie Gilliard. Coming off hot against Southeast Missouri, the Bearcats take a trip across the country to Corvallis, Oregon to take on the Oregon State Beavers, beating them 28-18. Rallying back home at Nippert Stadium, Kelly's Bearcats take on the Fresno State Bulldogs and extend their winning streak with a score of 28-20, aided by this pick from linebacker Craig Carey. Taking a short trip up to Oxford, Ohio, Cincinnati took on the Miami Redhawks for a rivalry known as the Battle of the Victory Belt, winning 37-13. Traveling south to the Sunshine State, Kelly's Bearcats face off against the University of South Florida. After throwing two touchdowns versus the Bulls, Tony Pike injures his wrist in the third quarter. Backup quarterback Zach Kolaris takes reign and runs all over the Bulls, throwing for 132 yards, one touchdown, and a 75-yard rushing touchdown. Back in Cincinnati, the Bearcats host the Louisville Cardinals in a rivalry known as the Keg of Nails. Zach Kolaris plays lights out, throwing 15-for-17 with 253 yards and three passing touchdowns. Running back Isaiah Pete also gets in on the fun, rushing for 88 yards and two touchdowns. Packing their bags and headed to the Empire State, the Bearcats ball out on both sides of the ball against the Syracuse Orange in the historic Carrier Dome. Zach Kolaris throws for 295 yards and four touchdowns, and the Bearcats defense never lets off the gas, forcing two turnovers. With two-thirds of the season complete, the Bearcats are back home at Nippert, hosting the UConn Huskies. Zach Kolaris plays the best game of his career, throwing for 480 yards, one passing touchdown, and rushing for two touchdowns. With the West Virginia Mountaineers in town, the Bearcats struggle severely in the first half. Kelly's Bearcats hold it together through the end as Pike makes a handful of appearances coming back from injury, throwing for two completions which resulted in touchdowns. Back like he never left, Pike leads his Bearcats to a win versus the Fighting Illini, recording the best game of his collegiate career, breaking the school's single-game passing touchdown record with 6 and his own career-high single-game passing yard record. With the Big East Conference title in sight, the Bearcats head to Pittsburgh and cap off their perfect season, coming from behind to win 45-44, finishing third in the BCS. As the 09 season came to a close, head coach Brian Kelly announces that he took the head coaching job at Notre Dame and won't be coaching the Bearcats in the Sugar Bowl. This taps in offensive coordinator Jeff Quinn as interim head coach versus Urban Meyer's Gators. Bearcats would end up losing in a blowout to star quarterback Tim Tebow 51-24. Although the road for the Bearcats ended at the Sugar Bowl, the 2009 team's legacy will be remembered as one of the greatest in history for years to come.